Do welcome back from that short break. And of course, we get to hit the timeline, getting up and to date. Of course, visit the timeline and let you know on what are some of the trending topics that you need to be part of. Now, of course, joining me as daily again right here, what is happening on the timeline?
Before I tell you what's happening on the timeline, if you don't have a broken phone like mine, then you're not using data. And therefore, you don't pay OTT tax. If you paid OTT tax, you'd be pressing your phone so hard that it cracks.
You cannot press your phone so hard that it cracks, Willis.
I'm a muchiga in my other life.
You are divided by swaying things.
Things. No.
Let's get into the timeline. What is happening?
Timeline, very big story that people had decided to ignore. Mm. The picture, the photo of Anselm, Dr. Besigye's son, coming on the internet, people decided to ignore the photo. I mean, it's his life and he's enjoying it. But for some reason, some people will not let it go. They won't let the guy be. And Queen Girl came up with a tweet and she said, the way people are judging Anselm, like they haven't touched boobs their whole lives.
Maybe it's not about touching the boobs. Maybe it is how he was touching them.
No, he was just touching. That photo, for me, would pass for a fighting cancer campaign. Breast cancer campaign.
We have some replies that did come through,
yes,
right there.
Niwagaba said, and he was just touching. Some of them are finishing breast milk for our future kids. Mm-hmm. Queen came through and said, you know, some actually bite and leave wounds. You see where the conversation headed?
Okay.
Someone said, wounds? Lol. Mm. Someone else said, why? We do, but not publicly.
Yes.
Which makes sense here. You know, in Uganda, you're not going to touch a woman's boobs in public.
I mean,
kissing
in public
like
is
that.
Seen as an immoral thing.
Yeah,
so clearly, by
it's
the time
close to immoral now. We
but
saw,
is it really immoral to just kiss your?
Well,
partner?
there are big people that we've seen kiss in public at the airport and, you know, public places. So it's bordering immoral. Someone came through and said, what's even wrong with touching publicly? It's just touching.
Just touching. Queen Girl.
Wama, they will touch you
when I want.
Yeah, because you only haven't seen his scary fingers. Otherwise, you would be in agreement with everyone. He had lots of rings on his fingers in that photo. So people were judging the guy, judging how he was touching the girl's boobs and stuff like that. Denzel came through and said,
had to comment on this one, didn't he?
Yes, let the guy enjoy his life. Let the guy be. Of course, if you've seen Denzel's photos and his nipple ring and his bow tie with a shirtless body and stuff like that, I mean, you would understand where Denzel is coming from. So Denzel, Anselm, kind of cut from the same cloth. So I believe, at the end of the day, I think that Anselm chose a life to lead. And we as Ugandans, we as young people, need to respect that. After all, he's not all the time in the country. He's abroad. He's living in a different society.
He's an adult. He's mature
enough.
Mm.
And we can't judge him using the yardstick that we judge people in Uganda. He's not here. He's spent most of his time abroad.
Abroad,
we can't say that he should be acting the way...
Who are we to even decide the kind of life he lives anyway?
No, people have the right to
decide. No, you don't have the right.
Because
it's my life.
Number one, Anselm is a son to Dr. Besigye.
So?
And Dr. Besigye was one of the people who campaigned and stood to be president of this country. And people have
the
what if... People have the what if question. What if Besigye had become president?
But
and that's why people have been comparing Anselm to Major General Muhoozi, and people have been comparing the two and saying, look at the first son. Then they were saying Omutabani Asoka.
My father being the opposition tycoon has nothing to do with my.
It
life.
Has everything
bearing
to do with
in
it
mind
because
that I've not even been living in the country.
Let me tell you, Derek. The moment you go into the public eye and try to work for the people, it is a service. It has ceased to be a personal issue. For example, there's an MP that lost a seat, a honorable minister that lost a seat in parliament, went back to the villages and cut out all the boreholes he had built and said, I will deal with these guys later. Now let them go and look for where to find the water from. I mean, you can't be acting like a hooligan, you know. So as a person, as a public
tit
figure.
For tat is a fair game.
As a public figure, your life, your family life matters to us. And therefore, we have the right to judge your kids and to judge you and stuff like that. Yeah. So
I wouldn't really agree with you on that. But anyway, we will never agree. Now, there's this interesting picture that is coming in from Mbarara because of the bull.
But
what is wrong with the people in Mbarara?
What is wrong? If you're watching from Barara, by the way, and you've seen the cow, the famous cow.
What is this guy's name? The mayor, the new elected mayor. What is his name? I forget his name.
He should be spearheading
this campaign. He has done actually tremendous changes down in Imbarara. Of course, they do thank him. Street lights, improved roads. But what is happening
to the famous cow?
And
of course, the tweet was brought to you by a very interesting tweet, Rakakamba Morrison.
Morrison, yes.
He's from Barara as well, that side. And he said, Barara, do something. Bull's horn is on thread. Thread what?
Threadbare.
What a monumental spectacle. It's a monument. It's that welcoming thing in Barara. When you go to Barara and you see the cow a kilometer ahead,
you know
I'm in the land of milk. I'm in the land of beautiful women. I mean, so I believe that something needs to be done. Back in the day when, you know, the rich people, the tycoons in Barara used to come, collect themselves and, you know, organize something and refurbish this famous cow. But I don't know what happened ever since we had the incident of Katatumba.
Kachebes, do something.
You need to do something about this cow.
Tuyambe.
Yes. Hey.
Moving away from that, what else is making...
Aside from the cow in Barara, let me just drop in a very funny tweet here. Have you ever put a WhatsApp status for someone and it expires before they view it? Have you ever done that?
No, I haven't.
Imagine Westjet took pictures, or maybe Bobby Wine took pictures, and he has Museveni's number, and he puts a status update, rocking Bujiri. And then 24 hours later, Museveni has
not checks the views, like, Museveni hasn't seen
and then viewed the status, very interestingly. But let's jump to Pastor. A very, very interesting tweet from Pastor Martin Semper at Martin Semper. He tweeted, state of gospel music in Uganda. Can you please give a caption for this photo? And the photo is of Exodus seated chilling with a bottle of Hennessy. Exodus has been accused constantly of, you know, partying, living
drugs,
and stuff like that. But he's kept on with his life. He's still enjoying his life.
I thought he had let go of that life because that is the exact person he was.
That's what we thought. That's what we thought. But again, when you see pictures coming through, I don't know if this photo is current. The tweet is current, but I don't know if the photo is current. Maybe this is an old photo and Pastor Sempa is trying to, you know, get retweets here and there. I mean, you've seen his tweets recently.
Maybe he wasn't drinking the alcohol. Maybe
but
was
then
just holding
he's
the
a public figure. He's a gospel artist. He has preached the gospel. He was once a ganja man.
Yes.
Yeah, but now a preacher man.
Yes.
How can you say back to being ganja man? As in, do we expect a song of back to ganja man?
It's actually a screenshot on Exodus's page because if you can see, it's Exodus UG.
Yes.
So this could be his Instagram.
Someone tweeted and said, they will tell you it is just gospel music, but I'm also aware of the struggles to fit in. I guess there's a lot of secular in the gospel world and it scares. But then if you want to hit the top, sell your soul. This is, in all honesty, it is sad. I believe that many artists, gospel artists, have crossed over into the secular world. You see the likes of I think Levickson, when he did Ponder Replay, the song Turn the Replay. The song is not really gospel, it's a party song.
It's a
party song, let's be honest with each other.
It's a party song.
Where
a gospel song is not supposed to be a party song.
Do churches have clubs?
You are literally saying that the people who go to church are not supposed to dance and sing.
No, they're not supposed to go to clubs.
No, but they can dance to their gospel songs.
Someone says, and this is Muhum Zaman, he's saying, hey, Pastor, did you know that this ninja was once arrested by the Kawunyemu guys? He was drunk as a fish. Gospel music might not have a problem, but the artists might have a problem.
Does anyone have facts to this? These are strong allegations,
we've seen Exodus in very compromising situations, and I've personally interacted with very many gospel artists who say that we cover for our brother. But otherwise, if we let out everything that happened to him, you people would have a field day. And I was like, what? So, I mean, such things happen. And I believe that, you know, the gospel world need to calm the guy down, talk to him, and probably help him come out of this situation.
There's another reply here coming in, of course, from Ediat3. He says that as long as the guy doesn't get intoxicated and do harm claiming he was under the influence, I see nothing wrong with having a glass of whiskey if you don't misbehave.
And of course, someone is going to quote verses from the Bible, from Proverbs, where it talks about don't be a drunkard, but it doesn't say don't drink. So you can drink as long as
God turned water into wine.
So you're going to bring those very funny quotes and not read. You're taking the Bible out of context. But anyway, that's a conversation that, you know, the gospel world needs to take on. And Martin Semper has started it. Let's just fall in and throw our ideas and see how to help a brother out of very many who are like him. Derek Ford Mugumisa tweeted and said, Uganda Cranes captain at Masinde Onyango, who has suffered a head injury last night playing for his club, has stabilized and sent out a video message to his teammates. He collided with an opponent and left the pitch in an ambulance. Very sad story for the Uganda Cranes and, of course, his club down there. But I believe that, you know, God has a plan for our brother. And that's why he's out for it. So, I'd say, I mean, quick recovery.
By the time he has release the video, then he's saying that he's actually in a much better situation. So, he's doing quite well.
There is a headline that was in the New Vision, I must say, and I'm saying this with a lot of reservations, but I'll say it. They were saying that guns were stolen from police, and then police retaliated and wrote a letter and said, no guns are missing at our classified stores. Today, they said the New Vision had their screaming lead story deep. Deeper trouble, 4,000 new guns missing in police. Police writes a letter there to clarify on the issue, and I love this because they came out, they've said something, they've clarified, and now we know that no guns are missing from police. So now at least
we are safe.
Yeah, there's that hope that we are safe.
Okay.
There's that hope that we are safe.
We hope this hope.
Yeah, so thanks for clarifying on that, Uganda Police UG. Now on to the biggest conversation that was started, of course, in Parliament, when there's this whole conversation of scratch cards and airtime via mobile money. I don't know what you think about that.
I think it's a good initiative. I mean, looking at the technology advancement, I think it's high time we do out with the scratch cards, honestly. Recharging with a machine or even with Airtel money is... It's very convenient.
Don't you think it's a way of government forcing Ugandans to use mobile money?
No, I don't think so.
Because they realize that Ugandans are not...
You can use mobile money or you can use the recharge machines from different outlets.
Recharge airtime machines.
Yes. So
either way, I can avoid mobile money.
Either way, you can avoid
mobile
money. Because,
of course, it's that...
And then there was also this whole conspiracy going around with scratching with your nails, apparently.
It causes cancer. Have you ever seen someone? Have you ever seen anyone?
I haven't. That's why I said it is a conspiracy.
Who even got cough? Because of using a scratch card.
I sneezed because of using a scratch card. Really? I scratched and then somehow I think I inhaled and then I sneezed.
How come you don't have asthma?
Because it didn't result into
asthma. Or maybe
it
you're too broke. Maybe you're too broke. You use airtime of 500.
No. See, that's why problem. You don't
have... If you are scratching 20K airtime...
It is not about how much you're scratching. It is about the fact that you scratch and whatever those particles are called. Do they have a scientific name for it anyway?
They are, I don't know. They are dust. Silver dust, I think. I'm not sure. Frank Tumwebaze.
Of course, it had to be Frank Tumwebaze.
Yeah, he came up and said he was. This is in response to a tweet where someone was saying, I wanted to buy airtime in town yesterday from mobile money. They were telling me they start from 5K, yet I needed 2K. The tweet goes on. Frank Tumwebaze retweets and quotes and says, we like to argue and oppose every new initiative, yet we are quick at admiring new advances and initiatives in other countries. Going digital is a solution to everything.
To all our problems.
A cashless economy is inevitable.
I mean...
Do you think, he makes a couple of points here. He says that we are quick to oppose every initiative in Uganda. This guy's come up with mobile money tax, we oppose. No scratch
card, media tax, we oppose.
Everything, we oppose. They're building for you a road, you oppose. But we are quick to admire Japan and admire Malaysia,
Rwanda.
And admire
just go down here
and
Rwanda.
Make noise. I think he makes a very valid point. What do you think?
I think for once I'm on his side. I'm on Frank's side because everywhere you go, you know, someone somewhere they are praising something in country A, B, C, D. But when the government is trying to have these initiatives to have, you know, someone look up to Ugandans like, hey, even me, I like Uganda because of A, B, C, D. Everyone will always come to oppose, and then they will say government agara huya senteza fe government. I think we should work on our mindset and look to the future. You know?
We tend to look at people in government as people who have come to collect.
There's this tweet coming in from Mutema who says there's also another research that mobile phones and computers may do the same. I'm patiently waiting for the ban of these unhealthy equipments. Engalabi.
Engalabi. MPs have noted that UCC official has not adequately sensitized the public on the need to go digital with airtime.
No, they have. Where have you have been?
Where have they sensitized?
They have sensitized. They have been on TV. They have been on radio. They have been in newspapers. Where do they? Where? They want to start moving house to house.
Yeah, they put posters.
No.
Did you see the posters of President Museveni during the campaign?
We shall not condone
their move.
They were everywhere.
Even on rubbish pits, they were there. Vote
did
for
you
Museveni.
Have to say that's rubbish pits?
They were there.
Let us close this show because.
But I believe that UCC needs to do more. They need to sensitize people.
I feel like UCC has done what it is supposed to do. Mm. We cannot start having this door-to-door services because we want to tell you about how to use mobile
money for
whatever
reason. Is this scratch card going digital viable for your auntie or uncle or grandfather in Kashari?
It is very viable for him because I know he's a wise man. A big thanks to the people that have been part of the show. And of course, the conversation does get to continue right here on The Timeline. At Wills Daily is his handle. And for my handle, it is at Iron Dash. We'll see you guys tomorrow for Turn Up Friday right here on Urban TV.